Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to express my utmost gratitude for the opportunity to speak at the third India Coal Outlook event. And as the Chief Executive of the World Coal Association, I am constantly highlighting the critical role of the coal value chain in both India and the world. Through meaningful and committed governmental and investment policy, our industry can transform into an environmentally and economically sustainable industry. Today, I would like to address three key points that serve as reminders to the coal industry and its critics. The first point: the global coal trends demonstrate that coal continues to be a vital energy resource for countries worldwide. The second: the global energy crisis and geopolitical issues have exacerbated the significance of coal to provide secure, reliable, and affordable energy. And lastly, the future of coal is yet to be written. This gives us an opportunity to seize a new coal movement and transformation that is centered around advanced coal abatement technologies and processes. We can enable coal-dependent nations such as India the ability to achieve their climate goals while providing reliable energy for their growing population. And let's start with the first point. The global coal reserves production and consumption underscore the significant role of coal in providing energy worldwide, despite the growing push to eliminate its use. The distribution of proved coal reserves and production paints an interesting picture of the key industry players. The United States leads with 23.2% of reserves, followed by the Russian Federation, 15.1%, Australia, 14%, and China, 13.3%. Europe collectively holds almost 13% of the global reserves. India, as a nation, possesses the fifth largest coal reserves, accounting for about 10% of global supply. In terms of production, the Asia-Pacific region dominates with almost 76%, including major contributors like China, India, and Indonesia. China stands out as the leading consumer, responsible for about 55% of global coal demand, followed by India at 12.4% and the United States at 6%. So it is important to be reminded of these figures as they demonstrate the significant role coal plays in energy production and consumption worldwide, particularly in emerging markets such as India. It also illustrates the global significance of coal with the Asia-Pacific region, led by China and India, which not only hold significant reserves, but also dominate coal production, consumption, and combustion. And countries like the United States, Russia, and Australia possessing substantial reserves. And even though many of those developed nations continue to suffer through policy environments which seek to penalize coal, we can see, as in Europe, that realities soon surface that cannot be ignored. Looking to the global coal trends, it is essential to recognise and discuss coal within a global context when we discuss the future of coal. The Statistical Review of World Energy for 2023 reveals some significant trends and figures that highlight the continued significance of coal as an energy resource. In 2021, coal consumption reached its highest levels since 2014, reaching 161 exajoules. This growth was primarily driven by China and India. While coal consumption in North America and Europe declined, non-OECD countries experienced an increase of over 6% in coal consumption. Global coal production also saw a significant surge, rising by over 7% in 2022 to a record high of 175 exajoules. China, India, and Indonesia played a pivotal role in driving this growth, accounting for over 95% of the overall increase. These figures underscore the continuing importance of coal as a global energy source. The surge of coal production is no surprise when we review the geopolitical upheavals across the world, particularly in Europe. In the last 12 months, Europe has continued to suffer a disrupted global energy industry. Part of the disruption is the Ukraine-Russia conflict, which has destabilized gas supplies. However, it is important for us as the World Coal Association and the coal industry at large to monitor and stay abreast of developments across the global arena. Germany exemplifies the challenges an economy can encounter in the energy context. The country's transition to green energy has resulted in high costs and an insufficient supply of renewables. The halt in Russia gas deliveries and the closure of nuclear power plants has further strained the energy situation, impacting German industries with worker shortages and outdated technologies. And this has led to some companies to seek opportunities abroad, raising concerns about Germany's economic decline and its implications for the European Union. Interestingly, and more telling of the energy crisis that has unravelled in Europe, is the realisation that renewables, as great as they are, do not offer the energy security and reliability that developed nations require. And a great example of this realisation is Sweden's latest energy turnaround, which abandons green energy targets and shifts focus back to an energy mix which includes nuclear power. Many countries like UK, Poland and Turkey are also prioritising energy security and diversifying their energy mix, which has led them to creating new opportunities for coal. Coal continues to be a critical, stable resource in meeting energy demands globally. And while consumption in North America and Europe has declined, non-OECD countries have conversely witnessed an increase. And the prime example of this is India. As you know, in India, coal plays a pivotal role in meeting the nation's energy requirements at the same time as driving economic growth through development. The Energy Institute Statistical Review of World Energy 2023 highlights that coal accounted for approximately 55% of India's total energy consumption in 2022. Currently, coal-fired power plants contribute to nearly 75% of India's power generation, making a significant contribution to the economy and employment. Ensuring energy security is of paramount importance for a developing nation like India, as it strives to eradicate energy poverty and achieve reliable and affordable energy access. Coal can play a crucial role in fulfilling these needs. As we embark on our transformative journey towards a sustainable future, it is imperative that we prioritise the development of efficient and cleaner coal technologies and utilisation. By embracing clean coal technologies, not only are we addressing present challenges, but we're also laying the foundation for future growth. With India's unwavering commitment to make in India, we must foster indigenous clean coal technologies to safeguard our energy security and propel us towards a resilient and environmentally conscious energy landscape. So how do we do that? Through responsible coal stewardship. Today, responsible coal and abatement stewardship is primarily driven by a diverse range of approaches and technologies, enabling advanced environmental oversight. Clean coal technologies are allowing responsible coal players to adapt to the climate challenge through innovation across the entire coal value chain. The coal industry has been innovating for solutions to real-world problems for more than 100 years, and clean coal technologies are the necessary next step in coal's sustainable journey. The value of clean coal technologies, such as CCS and CCUS, to our global decarbonisation efforts are confirmed by reputable climate science. Many countries across the globe have identified abated coal technologies, including HELE and CCS, in their Paris Agreement nationally determined contributions. It remains a little known fact, and the media are often incredulous when I say this, but up to 99% of coal emissions can be eliminated through abatement technologies and processes which currently exist. They extend from coal to hydrogen and coal to biomass to coal gasification, the latter which creates ammonia for fertiliser, which in turn bolsters food production. As set out in the ASEAN Plan of Action for Energy Cooperation, we know that clean coal technologies will be a central component to the ASEAN's energy transition. Our collaborative report with the ASEAN Centre for Energy provides comprehensive analysis and compelling evidence in support of clean coal technologies. It is online, so I won't go into too much detail, but suffice to say that in efforts to address the energy trilemma, the report acknowledges ASEAN's growing use of coal because of its relatively low costs and proven capacity to provide dispatchable baseload power, even with abatement technologies. Our challenge is to demonstrate to industry, governments, media, climate science, and other key constituencies how through the phasing in of clean coal technologies, coal can be accepted and understood as pivotal to delivering a sustainable net zero emissions future, consistent with the Paris Agreement and congruous with the 17 United Nations Sustainable Development Goals. What we are now seeing is the creation of a new coal movement, one which we hope can reposition, reframe, and rebrand coal by acknowledging coal's undeniable attributes. In short, we are about to see coal reimagined. And it is timely when you consider that the global population is growing and will number 10 billion by 2050. This population will be highly urbanized and living in dwellings constructed from steel, cement, and aluminium. They will need reliable, affordable energy. Coal will underpin this development. That alone should tell us that we should not be humouring any discussion about a transition away from coal and innovative abatement solutions. To do so would be unwise. Future coal and abated coal, to me, are synonymous. Abated coal is a catchphrase we use in the World Coal Association to describe the best available technologies and processes to transform our industry and pave our way to the future. It is a vision that is beyond combustion and inclusive of the opportunities to create coal ecosystems and circular economies. Coal to hydrogen, coal to fertilizers, coal to chemicals, coal to critical minerals, to name just a few. We need to articulate and actualize what we want this new future brand of coal to be: clean, economic, sustainable. But I want to be clear. Unification of the coal value chain and collaboration is key. We are not going to reach future coal without collective ambition and the ability to form cooperative partnerships with governments, investors, and the wider industry. So for our part, we have created a different platform leading a new coal conversation, one based on inclusion, fueled by collaboration, and mired in the facts. It allows for the coal value chain to share and joint venture in the collective ambitions to achieve global development and decarbonisation goals. Facts remain coal's most powerful asset, and we devote huge amounts of time ensuring that our narrative is factual, not emotional, and certainly not populist. I have listened to a number of you, and I hope now you can see that our organisation, under the evolving coal vision, represents a vision for a future-focused, robust market for both metallurgical and thermal coal, supporting coal's enduring journey. We are fortunate to have built an impressive and innovative alliance of members here in India, including Coal India, and we look forward to welcoming many more of those members across the coal value chain, including those members from the steel, cement, and power sectors. These discussions, which are underway, demonstrate to me that members are acutely aware of the coal ecosystem and the need to collaborate. Moreover, that they must own the narrative and therefore defining the sustainability of their business models. This year, we have witnessed how singular energy systems do not work. In countries like India, we know it is important to run secure, reliable, affordable, and diverse systems. We need to be leaders and participants in the global community's objectives, but we must firmly have a clear vision for our national agenda. And to do that, we must work together to achieve a new coal vision, one which balances economic, social and environmental development in equal measure and in a truly sustainable way. To honour the great Mahatma Gandhi, we must walk together to achieve the change we want. I want to thank you for this honour to speak with you, and I wish you a fruitful and engaging conference ahead. Thank you.